So, my name is Julius. I'm an interviewer. He's my secretary, Calvin. He is my second secretary, Kevin Floyd. Thank you for your time. It is a pleasure of interviewing you. See the purpose of it. Our purpose of an interview is to gain knowledge on why street food consumers, like sales students, continue to consume street food, knowing that there's a risk due to a variety of factors. So our first question is, what is your favorite street food?
My favorite street food is bread. Because it has good feeling and it's delicious.
So it's do you think it's fresh?
I think it's fresh because it was made by.
Or are you doubting? Do you have doubts that it is fresh?
I'm not sure about that. But as long as I eat fresh bread, it's good.
You can speak it again.
Okay.
You have a, is it your favorite or do you also go with other street foods?
Oh, nang may type ko sa Spanish bread ay pwede man iba kay as long ang mga kaon ka lang ay nauputo ka lang.
Okay. As long as it feels you na, as long as it satisfies you. It's what do you think is street food popular?
Sa ako nga nagpopular na kay Damo Mega Bakbal sa mga kalabanan sa mga estudyante. Kay kita nga Pilipino na namita sa ating sa mga street food. Iskan ano pa na ibo nila kay sikat na mo mga isaw, barbecue, French bread, kalipan.
Also, when you buy street food, you also consider the flexibility it gives you. Because when you buy street food, you get to take it anywhere, and it allows you to walk and eat. As compared to ICA and Stingers, you can't just walk and you know. You really have to go to a table, settle down, and take time to eat. Whereas street food, you can consume it on the go. While walking, you can do it.
Can you repeat?
Can you give more reasons as to why you like street food?
Okay, that's the point. Because I like street food a lot. Why I didn't think that Stingers.
Knowing that street food provides little or no beneficial nutrients, in other words, unhealthy, why do you think consumers like you continue to buy street food?
Sa ako, yung kapakain ko parang street food kay ang mula lang isang barato sa ako, yung kay kalabanan ng mga pagkaw dahil sa silahan. So, Boulevard dahil ang price.
It costs a lot.
Yeah. While in street food, kay siyempre, barato lang niya, mapuso kapag hindi na. Sa isa lang, di ka 20 pesos, apat ka naka-Spanish bread, kita hindi ka lahat. So, gusto ka na makatipid ka pa sa imo.
And there are barely anything that you can buy in 20 pesos, right? Whether
yes.
It's Stingers or
something. In Stingers, I think you buy just 20 pesos. I think juice. Mm-hmm. Now, 20 pesos juice just in 12 ml. But in on other store, when you buy 20 pesos of juice, it's just a cup, and it's a bowl of like balloons.
Okay. seems as long as it satisfies you, you'll continue to buy it and consume it. Do you agree?
Yes, because like, syempre, nanamita mo ko sa mga, ano, sa mga staple, kaya, amo nang ga-satisfy sila sa akin kay, kay parati niya pa namin. Kaya hindi kit siya kay ito ka-ati niya kung kao.
Moving on from nutrition aspects to more sanitary aspects, do you think street food vendors practice a sanitary way of preparing and serving food?
Sa ako, yes. Kay di man nila gusto ng haluan ng mga customers. Kay, you know, kay gusto nila makakuha-kwarta para sa ina bata, mga para sila future na kabalo ko ginatinduan ng iba kerbi para sa
utensils. But did you know that some vendors don't practice, maybe some or most of the vendors don't practice sanitary?
Sometimes na I didn't see in the Philippines, but I only saw in India. They're just using like the dirty hands, just they're picking up all the things and just in the pan.
Have you seen the vendor use his hands also in the Philippines when choosing the food?
Yes, but they are using gloves or plastic to protect bacteria or some dirty.
However, the washing and cleanliness of these
that's the problem. Kay wala gid ko may nakakita ang gawas sila tubig. Idol kasi sila kabor. Pero ang ginayang problematic kay siyempre kung once mo may makita ka matatlo ka na tumalain na sila dito. So di na magpakadlan eh.
If vendors were to follow a sanitary way of preparing and selling their food, do you think this would benefit Liceo students and other customers of street food? If vendors were to follow a sanitary way of preparing and selling their food, do you think this would benefit Liceo students and other customers of street food? If they use a sanitary way of preparation?
Kung nagamit sila sanitary way, feeling ko ma-accept din sila sa mga schools kay siyempre kung depende na lang sila sa hygiene ka responsibilities.
I have a question for you. What will you do if you see some flies in the food?
If I see flies in the food, I'm sure as obvious na hindi ko bitay ako ng chip na kung may nakita ko flies ka. Ano ko sila yung bag ko sila sa yung bag ko na may flies ka sa isaw ka. Ma-aware din sila lang na next time na i-check nila kayo ang ilang ingredients ka kayo.
How would you what are the options that you would take if you saw flies?
My options.
Yeah, what would you do if you were flies? Other than telling the vendor, would you avoid the food completely?
Yes, I would avoid the food because you know flies touch many things like garbage, dirtiness, like that. I'm sure most people can touch anything because material can't see anything, but as long as you see it, you will be in any.
But do you also consider that there are parts of the food, for example nuts, many on top, the flies touch it, but also underneath, do you also consider that or like Would you look for another way to eat that street food?
Yes. I would say you want to do the address now, which is not the convention is over. Yeah, for sure.
So,
I know what? Yeah, I just get it. Right? Let's not
So, for example, street food, if you saw one flying touch the street food, touch the Spanish bread, would you avoid that part of that one single Spanish bread?
Or would you also buy others? I would take it. Kasi sa mga naka-flies, kaya hindi matatyo sila. Kaya Spanish bread, kaya kinubun na aron kung hindi mo bakit na.
However, okay, fine. Still same question. If the vendors do practice sanitary way, there will be an increase in price because they will have to wash and keep washing and washing the utensils, and then they have to spend for that water.
Okay pa lang kay kung nagtaas makita guys, pero ang iba din yung tao, syempre bago yung sistema, alawa yung nagtaas ang price. Pero ang concept ko na sa work kay kung sila po yung gagabi pa sila galingin na good way. So, sa ako, hindi kami ko lang tayo.
As long as they increase the price with a good reason. Suppose you have been buying Spanish bread from a particular vendor for a while. If you caught the vendor practice an unsanitary method of preparing it, would you still take the risk of buying it? Yes.
Now, of course. Now, if I saw them making wrong ingredients, honestly, I don't want to pay them. Mungkin sila salah mukai kasi patay na naka ilag ba, patay na kasi tubo na sa mga tao. Kabalo ko nila yung opasyon, pero sure ko yan, not to problem. Okay. Tamutang ko, we just said ko na own noun ingredients.
For example, I was buying Spanish bread from the vendor, and I saw the compartments, the yellow boxes that you see. The bottom box was open and exposed to the ground. It is next to the ground, and all of the particles and all the germs, all the dirt can go to the uncooked street food and will later be served to the people. So, what do you think about that?
Can you repeat?
What are your thoughts? What are your opinions on that situation?
I think it's just for to cover something that to avoid. To avoid your dirtiness, just to enter in the box.
Because I saw that it was open next to the ground. So this is the box, the ground, and the bottom box was open. So all the dirt and all the dirt that can enter inside the...
So I think
Are you discouraged?
Yes.
If you saw something like that, would you consider buying other foods, cheap foods? If you saw a situation like that, would you consider buying or avoiding Spanish bread after seeing that situation?
If I know.
If you saw that situation happen, when you're buying street food, would you look for other options? Other street food?
Think,
or would you still buy street Spanish food?
I think no. Because it's so very disappointing that if I see that certain things that game sila sa lab, do mo feeling hangi ko ya iba niya kay kay topa to pala it para check kay ya pa sa mga tao na hindi pa baka ay do di man na kay to pala it kay syempre kay gay mo pa sila for kay mo pa sila business para maka tuloy sa atin.
But would you tell them? Would you talk to them?
I would talk to them. As a student, they yung bagay sila na. Ano lang yung why mata power? Mahalik sila. Yung balahan sila na face na ang ginagawa.
Suppose you got ill due to the poor sanitation practiced by the vendor. Would you still continue to buy?
Sa ako, hindi. Ay, syempre,
if you got really ill, does it depend on how? Does it depend on how ill you are? If you're really really ill, and
if I really really ill.
Suppose you got cholera.
Oh, if I don't want to eat anymore, I will just stay to the what doctor say if I get ill. I will prefer a diet of what
how important is street food here? How important is street food here?
To me, if it's a clean, yes, it's clean. Spanish bread is important to me because, okay, siya lang for me ang gaano sa ako, kapag nakit, kapag lalagay niya sa baka sa ako, kapag-port, kaya mo na siya importante sa ako, okay? Kung wala man din steak po, do wala wala diyan pa. Do wala wala diyan po. Oh, syempre kay kag culture lang sa sa Pilipinas. Kag iban man nga bansa kay amo gini ang steak po kay namit na ang steak.
And it's important for the economy of the country. It helps changing of money. If there's no street food, there would be basically, it's an important income. It's how the country gains money from its people. So, what are the possible reasons you would buy from ICA or Stingers rather than street food?
I think kung example, may fish bowl, may salape. Salape is a Filipino fish bowl. Yang fishbowl yang itu hook doa nila ang bihim itu homemade na mga hari na lang yan. So kung sa ICA stickers kaya balo ko ang mga ilang ano ingredients kapa ano na gitula ano ka proper na gila kapa high quality kay sa steak food ya kapa balo ko kapa instant lang na pero ginahin mo man nila as a proper. Siguro ang mga pakalkulang puro sa 20 pesos sa ICA, ano lang puro. So, hindi na. Ano na media? Oh, potato turnip.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no, ano na?
It's not that expensive, right?
Oh, expensive. It's just one, ano, and it costs 8 pesos today.
Oh.
Yes, every other. Potato burner, and I saw it potato burner. Just small price, very regular. Just too small. If it's too super joke, I know only rich people can do that.
Okay. Would it be better if the street food was more costly but safer? Yes. Sir.
Both. Okay. I. Okay. Siyempre, importante ang
Have you spoken to any vendors concerning the food just now?
In my whole life, wala pa. I just asked ako sila ko sa tagpila nila.
Have you seen the vendors practice on that sanitary way of
operation? Wala. Yeah. May nakita ko siguro, pero hindi lang. Hindi sa still.
You buy from the street food, the Spanish bread vendor often, right?
What?
You buy from the Spanish bread vendor often, right?
Oh, yes.
Most of the times you would buy from buy Spanish bread.
Yes, mostly.
Do you know what time they operate, the person with the occupancy?
What?
Do you know what time they sell?
I think that time they sell.
The person that, you don't have a specific person, the vendor. Like a seller.
Anakita ko lang sila per minute. No, 8 p.m. No, kita ko sila gala by per minute, mga 7:30. No, ako na pala. Okay, kabalo ko po asala, late ko per minute.
When you buy street food, you normally see a change in vendors, right? It's not the same person that's selling it. So, for you, it doesn't really matter if it's same vendor or different vendor, as long as you get the food.
Sa akin, okay malang.
Okay, so that's it. Thank you for your time and cooperation. I assure you that you'll get a copy of what had happened during the interview. It will be given, so whatever you said there has been beautifully written, and you have the option to change it. Yeah, so, thank you.
Thank you.